Well, it is that time of year again when seasonal businesses are looking to find people to fill all those jobs at the hotels and inns along Maine's coast. And many of the larger hotels turn to foreign workers in order to fill that void. But this year, something different. Those foreign workers who come for the summer are finding it a little bit tougher to get here. WMTW News 8's Jim Keithley is live in Wells tonight with more on this. Jim.
Tracy, foreign workers are telling stories of being interrogated for as many as 12 to 14 hours by U.S. officials before being allowed into this country. Now, the manager here at the Village by the Sea, where we are tonight in Wales, tells us that she hires mostly foreign students, but there are other resorts that hire adults from Jamaica. But what they're all finding is more scrutiny when they enter the U.S. Lily is a college student from Bulgaria. She's spending her summer here in Maine, cleaning rooms at the Village by the Sea. The general manager here says they've been hiring foreign workers for more than 15 years, mostly students like Lily who are here on a J-1 visa or work and travel visa. Gail Phillips says she's still waiting for one of her student workers to arrive.
I've encountered more problems this year than ever on my bringing them in. I've been hearing that there's been issues with the embassy interviewing people, and it's being delayed primarily because of the bombing in Boston, is what I've been told from my foreign workers.
Just down Route 1 in Ogunquit, Merlene is busy tending to her duties at the Meadowmere Resort. She's been coming back to Maine to work for the last 8 summers. She tells us she spent 3 hours being interrogated by immigration officials when she flew from Jamaica to Miami. Even with all the paperwork proving she had a legal work visa, a long list of questions came.
They're saying, like, when they're coming, they'd ask them how long they've been coming, the reason for coming.
It's very highly monitored.
Allison Cavarata says for the first time her foreign employees are being detained, some for as many as 12 to 14 hours, while U.S. officials are calling her asking for further proof that her employees are actually employees.
We had to be available for phone calls. We actually had to send them additional proof paperwork for them to travel with, which is unusual and in all of the years has never needed to be done before.
When we asked the Department of Homeland Security about this, we were told to send them an email. Our questions went unanswered.
People in immigration, they're doing their job, especially in light of recent events. They want to be sure that if they let somebody in here to do a job that needs to be done, that that's what they're here to do.
Now, Gail Phillips here at this resort says that the one worker she's been waiting for should have arrived about 2 weeks ago, leaving her shorthanded, and that is a whole other story here because resorts seem to can't find enough people to fill these jobs. And the catch is they can only have so many foreign workers on staff. We're live in Wells tonight. Jim Keithley, WMTW News 8.